Today, I'm going to show you how to set up a system for project management within your notes. This is going to be great for anyone who manages multiple projects, whether that is multiple companies and businesses, whether you have a side project along with your main job. Maybe you just want to keep track of the personal things happening in your life. Whatever it is, if you have multiple things that you're keeping track of, this system is really going to help you plan, organize, and execute on all of the tasks. So if you look on my left-hand sidebar here, you can see I've got a bunch of pinned notes here. Now I've done this all in a template specifically to show project management. So my map doesn't have anything except for my project management notes. And let's go through what the general structure is here. So I'll actually start on the bottom here. I have three projects outlined. Now these would have a project name. So maybe project one is Reflect and maybe project two is my side project startup cookie, and maybe project three is house maintenance because I own my home and there's a lot of things I need to do to it. And then I have this page here that just lists all of them backlinked and has a short description. I have this title set up here just because I like to pin this, and I'm kind of using it as a divider just to note that I have projects down here. Now on top here, you see I have a top priorities page, a task list page, a goals page, a project notes page, and a project ideas page. And these notes are all pinned to the left-hand sidebar so I can find them easily. And if I go to my mind map within Reflect here, Reflect has this feature. If your note-taking app doesn't, that's all right. This is kind of just a good visual tool here. You can see that I've got my three main projects and all of these are backlinked together. So if I look at project one here and I look closely, I can see the lines going out to each of the components. So you can kind of all see how the system just gets linked together nice and organized from the map. But let's start by going through these pages one by one and showing you how to develop them. So first off, we're going to want to create the project pages. So I'm going to start with project one here. And these are all going to look pretty much the same because I have these categories divided. And you'll notice that each of these category tabs here correlates to the note pinned on the top. And that's because that is that note backlinked directly. So if I expand this bullet here, I've got three sampled priorities. So this was my Reflect work. Maybe priority number one is building content as a growth channel. Maybe my priority number two is improving onboarding, and so on and so forth. But I just kind of put fillers in for this so that you can see how it works. Now, what's nice here is that if I go to, well, first let me show you project two. We've got the same thing here. Again, different tasks, just with different labels, and same thing on project three. Now, if I go to the top priorities note, because that's backlinked, these all show up in the incoming backlink section. So if I just want to ever see a list of all of my top priorities across all of my projects, I can just click into this page. And even though the note itself is blank, all I need is the priorities down here. And as I change them within the project pages, they will be changed into here. So if I go in here and let's just say this is a new one, so I'll give it a new label and I go into my top priorities, this will get updated in the project one down here to have the new label there. So everything gets updated automatically. It's very, very nice. All you have to do is keep the project pages updated. So that's top priorities. The next categories work the exact same way. So task list. These are the tasks that you can think of that you just need to accomplish. And they'll probably be, well, hopefully be related to the top priority. And this can work like a mind dump. You can use this space to just list every single task that you need to, or that you think you might need to do for a project. And then of course you can sort them by priority after you dump them all in to make sure that you're doing them in the right order according to your top priorities. And again, you're going to do this for project number two, task list, project task one. That's my labeling system there. But again, these will be actual tasks. And same thing for project number three. And same thing as before, if we click on task list, either here or under the pinned note, we see all of the tasks that I need to accomplish for each of the projects. Now, that means for my daily note, if I'm in here, let's say, today this is part of the video that I'm doing, but let's say that I'm going to do a new one, like I usually do on days, and just call it a to-do list. So we'll say to-do, and underneath there, I can just start a checklist. But actually, that was foolish of me. Let me backlink this. Oops. I'll backlink that to my task list. And if I wanted to, I could open this up in a split pane. And I can just see all the tasks that I need to do. And I could just copy and paste them into this list here. I could write them out manually and just kind of take them from each one. And you'll also see now that Tuesday, this day, appears in the task list down below. So all the days that we tap into this task list, it will appear down below. And we can just kind of keep on going there for the daily note. And anytime we need to know what tasks need to be accomplished, we can just click on the task page. All right, so let's go to the next category. Again, I'm going to go back into the note here and let's go to goals. So goals, and again, you can order these however you want. If I were doing this from a kind of top-down planning section, I would probably go top priority goals, then into the task list. But recently I've been doing my tasks directly off of my priorities. So I've kind of ordered mine in this way. But here, this one's a little bit more intricate here. So this is going to assume that you're doing your goal planning by different time increments. So we can see at the bottom here, we've got annual goals, all going up into quarterly goals, into monthly, into weekly. And I didn't include a daily because that's just kind of what I call daily tasks that happen within the daily note. And now if I were doing this, I would kind of go through and create a new section here for each year, for each quarter, for each month, and for each week. So for example, for monthly goals right now, we're in July. So for this, I would put monthly goals, July. And these pages work the exact same as the larger categories did because they are backlinked. And again, I have this the exact same way. Let me collapse these so it stays nice and clean. And you can see I have the same thing for these other projects here. And that means if we go to the goal page, we can very easily see all of the goals for each time here across all of our projects here. So I can go into any specific project, project three here, and see what the goals are for any given year. I can make my quarterly goals based off that annual goal. I can make the monthly goals based off the quarterly goals and the weekly goal based off of that. And again, these should of course be tied into your top priorities, but in this video, I'm going to talk about the system more than how you should actually be setting your priorities and goals. So I think this one is actually one of the most beneficial ones because goal setting and tracking can get a little messy, especially when you go from tasks. But you can see here how this, I guess, kind of cascade happened here. You can set the goals, maybe do your planning for at the beginning of the year, at the beginning of the quarter, at the beginning of the month or week, or maybe at the end of the previous one. And then you have your goals, set your top priorities. Those should be related to those. And then create your tasks list based on those. And that is essentially the project management system here, is it allows you to kind of say, these are the most important things, and here's exactly how I'm going to get there. Now you'll see here, I have two more categories here. This is a little bit less project management and just more kind of personal organization that I like. I like to have a project notes section here, and these are just is going to be a simple bullet list. And in here, you can put anything that you would like for any of the projects. So if, you know, something happens, someone says something or a suggestion that you just want to remember, you can put it in the notes there. And again, if you ever need to access all of those, they will be in the backlink section. And similarly, you could actually include this in the notes section, but I like to have a separate one that just says project ideas. And again, that's kind of the last category we have here within each of the projects. And you can just put any ideas you have there. This makes it really easy when you have an idea to just go through and quickly find the pinned notes. You can either go to project ideas and find the right project here, or you can go into the project and add it yourself. So now after seeing all those, the map might make a little bit more sense. And now that we have added a task list into that day, we can see it connected to the task list. And if you keep on backlinking within your daily notes, you'll be able to see exactly what you worked on what day with these projects. So the system's actually quite simple. It doesn't take that much work to set up. And it's quite fun to do because it actually is just goal planning at the end of the day and doing your priorities across all the projects. It's also very nice because you can create endless projects here. So if I wanted to create a new note that just said, you know, project four, I can add that, pin it, and drop it all the way to the bottom here. But I can even just go into these existing ones and, you know, uncollapse all of them, copy them all, and I can then go through here, paste them into the new page, and just kind of clear out these and replace them with the information that I wanted. So it's a very scalable system. And once you retire projects, you can just remove them from this list here, but you'll still find them backlinked within these pages. So if you ever need that information, it will be waiting there for you. So highly recommend giving the system a try. Again, very simple for your own personal project management. However, if you wanted to, you could apply this to a team setting as well in a different application that is more collaborative. But I think it's very important to kind of nail your own priorities, your own goals down first, and then break them into tasks so you know exactly what to do on any given day.